Hey guys, so today is the last 16 game between Spain and Russia. I've just been filming next to the river here in Moscow. You can actually see Luzhniki in the background there. And I actually met a very interesting person today. His name is Daniel, and he was asking a lot about my YouTube channel. So he's just come back on his skateboard. So I thought I'd ask him a little bit about the World Cup. Hey Daniel, how's it going?
Hello, how are you?
I'm good. So you were talking about the World Cup, weren't you? And like you're saying, you're really enjoying all the fans being here.
Yes, I'd like to meet many people from foreign countries, because for Russia it's not always like that, because we didn't have much opportunity to communicate with such people, and I'd like to do this more practice. And of course I'd like World Cup because it's so interesting, so kindful, so emotional, I can say.
But your English is really good, so did you learn it at school?
Yes, learning it at school and some in university, but I don't think my English is good.
It is good, trust me, I can understand. It's very good.
Thank you.
So how about, like, have you been enjoying watching Russia play? They've obviously gotten through to the last 16, doing so well. And every time I've been around here, there's so many Russian fans everywhere. They're all enjoying it, aren't they?
Yes, it is so great to communicate with our teams, our fans of our teams. They are so
passionate.
Yes,
yeah. Like
football. It's I think it is a great to Russia to have this time in World Cup.
And do you think they'll beat Spain today?
I don't know.
It's a hard game.
I think it's so. Yeah? It will be so. I don't know. Maybe 1-1.
Okay, 1-1. That'll be interesting. That's Daniel there. Really lovely to meet you. And you're going to be watching my YouTube channel. Oh. But you're going to be on it now.
Okay. I'd wish to 1,000, 1 billion subscribers to you. Subscribe your channel. Thank you for watching.
Right guys, so Spain have been knocked out of the World Cup by host Russia. The game ended 1-1 after full time and after extra time, because it went to extra time, and Russia beat Spain 4-2 on penalties. I almost don't know where to begin, but I'll begin with Spain, because they were comfortably in the lead. It was an own goal. I know Sergio Ramos celebrated like he had scored the opener, but he didn't score the opener. It was an own goal. And Spain were pretty comfortable. They were dominating proceedings. And Piqué handled the ball inside the area. Now, a lot of people have actually messaged me saying, that was not a handball. It was a handball for me. Definite penalty. And Russia conveyed it. And basically, with scoreline at 1-1, it just suited Russia down to a T. They defended well, they defended in numbers, they defended deep, and they basically invited Spain on, and they basically said to Spain, well, you need to find a way past the defence if you want to go through, and Spain didn't have an answer. I was a little bit surprised at some of the, well, the starting lineup, yes, some of the changes, yes, and in the end, I just think they, you know, Russia wanted penalties, they got penalties, and they've gone through. And I just think Spain, they were just so poor. Now, I went to the mix zone afterwards and I spoke to the Spanish Football Federation's president, Luis Rubiales, and he spoke to me quite at length actually about, well, I asked him about the sacking of Julen Lopetegui before the World Cup, and I said, has it negatively affected Spain's World Cup campaign? And he basically said, look, we've passed that chapter. And he's completely convinced, as is the board, that Spain are on the right track. I mean, I think I speak to some Spanish journalists after the game. They don't think that Spain are on the right track. I did ask him as well what Spain need to do now to kind of rebuild themselves, and all he would say is, look, we're gonna come back stronger next European Championship, next World Cup. And I also asked him about Fernando Hierro, and I said, you know, will he be staying on as Spain manager? And he said that will be sorted out in a couple of weeks now. If you want to see the full interview with Luis Rubiales, then you can go to the Evening Standard's website, because I have written it up now. But it was very interesting. He was being very, very kind of... He was being very adamant that he made the right decision to let Lopetegui go just a day before the World Cup started. And, I mean... Who knows what could have happened had Lopetegui stayed. I think they would have gone further. But today was pretty dismal display. I mean, the Spanish players looked... They were down. They were kind of walking out in single file out of the stadium. And I don't know, it was such a poor game. But for Russia, I mean, what a story this is. I actually predicted Russia would get out of the group stages. But I didn't today think that they would beat Spain. And they have beaten Spain. And it sent the fans here wilder, and I feel like it's good in a lot of ways because it's kind of united all the fans here, and it's gotten them into a World Cup that they are hosting, and they're through to the quarterfinals. It's a great storyline. I hope you've enjoyed my vlog today. It's been a really long day. It's going near mid. It's nearly midnight now. But I have enjoyed watching my first last 16 game at a World Cup. And the next game for me is another last 16 game, but this time it's England's game with Colombia. Really looking forward to that game. Obviously, I get to see my team England in action. I hope we go through to the quarterfinals. But I'll be back from Spartak Moscow Stadium in a couple of days with another vlog from that match.